Never use a singleton. You hear that a lot, but are they always bad? And singletons come up a lot in iOS developer interviews, so today you'll learn what is a singleton, the pros and cons of a singleton, and when and where to use them. Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. What is a singleton? A singleton is an instance of a class that can only be created once and is globally accessible throughout your codebase. Let's take a look at an example of a singleton that Apple itself uses, UserDefaults. UserDefaults is how we persist data onto the device. For example, if I wanted to show this onboarding screen only the first time my app is ever used, I would store a Boolean like isFirstUse into UserDefaults so that the screen only shows once. Here's the key question to ask yourself before creating a singleton. Is it vital that there is only a single instance of this class? If a second instance were to be created, would that mess things up? And UserDefaults is a great example of this because we want that persisted data to be consistent. Imagine if every time we wanted to fetch from UserDefaults or write new data to UserDefaults, we created a new instance of it. So now this example of isFirstUse, well, in some UserDefaults it would be true, sometimes it would be false, right? You can see how it would be very inconsistent. So you see why it's vital for there to only be one UserDefaults. So anything we store in there is going to be the same when we go to fetch it. By the way, that dot standard after UserDefaults is the shared instance of UserDefaults, which makes it a singleton. I'll tell you about that later in the video when I break down the anatomy of a singleton. Now for the pros and cons of a singleton. The first pro is that there can only be one. It's unique. So if uniqueness is what you need, like we did in that UserDefaults example, there you go, singletons are good for that. The second pro is also a con, which we'll talk about in a little bit, but it's convenient. Remember, your codebase has global access to that singleton. So in the example of UserDefaults, no matter where I am in my app, no matter what file, I can call UserDefaults.standard and either fetch or write new data to it, doesn't matter where I am. But I wanna be clear, if the only reason you chose a singleton is because it's convenient, you're doing it wrong. That is not the way to go. The main reason you choose a singleton is because you need that uniqueness. You need there to only be one instance of this class. Creating a second one would mess things up. The convenience is just a bonus. Now for the cons of a singleton, and we'll start off with that global accessibility, that convenience that I just talked about. Because you can imagine, if you have a big code base, you see all these files, and all of these files can access that shared resource, you know, that singleton. Well, you can imagine, you know, this file might be updating the singleton, which could cause a bug in another file. So you can see how it can quickly turn into this spider web if, you know, hundreds of files can all access and make changes to this singleton. It can lead to some very tricky bugs. So you gotta be careful with that. And because all those files are accessing the singleton directly from their file, that makes testing pretty tricky because, you know, the functions in that file may rely on data from the singleton, but it's coming from an external source. It's not all self-contained in that function. So testing gets tricky. Along those lines, the whole separation of concerns that's good for programming, that gets real muddy because again, all these files down here are accessing the same resource. However, a common way to fix this issue is to use dependency injection to inject your singleton into these files rather than accessing the singleton directly from the files. Dependency injection is a topic for another video. That's coming soon. Before I dissect a singleton and show you exactly what makes a singleton, let me tell you about today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves, but I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. How do you create a singleton? How do you guarantee that only one of them can be created? Well, here I have a simple example, and I kept it simple because really there's only two steps. The first step in the class of my singleton is the static let shared equals my singleton. So here I'm creating a property called shared, and I'm initializing an instance of my singleton, the class. Now, the second line is what guarantees the uniqueness, this private init. So the initializer is private. I can't initialize an instance of my singleton from outside of this class. So if I can only initialize the class MySingleton from within the class, that's exactly what the static let shared equals MySingleton is doing. I'm initializing that instance. And then now, anytime I want to use MySingleton, for example, you see the function down there, do something, that's on MySingleton, I call MySingleton.shared do something. So how you use your singleton is that dot shared. And that's exactly what we were doing in user defaults when we did user defaults.standard. Or you may see file manager, filemanager.default, or URL session, url session.shared. To be clear, that dot shared, dot default, dot standard, that's just the name. Typically you see dot shared in singletons, but they're all doing the same thing. They just chose to name it default and standard or shared. It's the same thing. So are singletons the worst design pattern in iOS? No. Singletons are a tool just like a hammer. A hammer can be used wonderfully to make beautiful things. A hammer can also be used to do some pretty bad things. Singletons have a bad reputation because they are easily abused, and a lot of developers abuse them. So use them sparingly, don't overuse them, and you'll be all right.